with the 12th pick in the 2014 NFL Draft, the New York Giants select Odell Beckham, wide receiver, LSU.
What's up, guys? You here with Coach T.
And this is Coach J. We're here live from sunny Southern California. We're here to talk a little bit about the infamous, the incredible, the amazing Odell Beckham.
I mean, just look at this guy. This guy is a physical specimen. I mean, we only get a few players like this, a couple decades. But he has made a lot of headlines in the last 2 months. What do you think, Coach?
Yeah, man, and this guy is an incredible playmaker. But despite that, you know, he's been in the headlines for some pretty gnarly stuff. But, you know, that's what happens when you're an A-list athlete like he's become. And that's a function of his talents. I mean, yeah, there's people in the news saying some pretty crazy stuff, but I mean, this guy is the ultimate playmaker.
I mean, I agree with you. I totally agree with you. It makes me wonder why the Giants are ready to put him up for auction. I mean, this guy is New York. I mean, without New York, there's no Beckham. Without Beckham, there's no New York.
I mean, look at that route that he just made, man. I mean, this guy is a playmaker, but I think after a while, despite, you know, his playmaker abilities and the fact that the Giants have been losing, you know, even though he's been on the field, yes, we know he's been hurt, but they haven't really been winning all that much. And I think they're a little bit tired of the off-the-field press and antics because, I mean, Odell, he's kind of become bigger than the NFL. I mean, what you think, Coach?
I mean, I think this guy can be a distraction. I mean, look at him. When he doesn't get the ball, he's crying, he's yelling, he's kicking, he's screaming. I mean, he even assaulted a kicker's net. And guess what? The kicker net wasn't taken, and it assaulted him right back in his face.
Yeah, that was pretty funny. I mean, the guy, he has raw emotion, but you got to appreciate that. You know, he is one of the emotional leaders on the team. Yeah, the guys on the rest of the team, they really feed off of his energy and playmaking ability. So it kind of comes with the territory. I mean, it's kind of tough to have that much raw talent but be maintained as an athlete. And so with his ability comes the raw emotion. I mean, look at that catch, man. I mean, this guy, he is a top-notch athlete. He made that catch as a rookie. I mean, this guy is amazing.
I mean, I agree. I mean, that is one of probably the best catch I've ever seen. And quite frankly, maybe the NFL has ever seen. I mean, that catch is phenomenal. But, I mean, the Giants did go 3-13 last year. This guy is in the headlines. I mean, let's talk about the Giants. I mean, they benched Eli Manning. I mean, you don't bench Eli Manning. And the result of that, they fired the head coach and the GM. So, it sounds like a lot of upstairs things are really crumbling at the moment in the New York Giants front office.
Yeah, they're not really a stable organization right now. That tends to really mess up just the dynamic of the squad. But I mean, look at this guy. He's jumping over athletes. He's having a really good time. You want that kind of dynamic in the locker room, that kind of positive energy. If you know, things on the front in the front office at the top are kind of falling apart. I mean, if you're benching your quarterback and then you're getting rid of your best player. I don't know, man. It's not looking so good for the Giants organization.
I mean, going 3-13, you got to rebuild at some point. And I can understand the move by trading Odell because, quite frankly, you'll get a lot of value. Look at that catch. Oh, my gosh. Look, in traffic, look at the concentration. Look at his hands, his hand-eye coordination. I mean, this guy is a freakish athlete. Now, rumor is that he might be coming to L.A. I mean, L.A. might need him. L.A. just beefed up their defense. I mean, they got two Pro Bowlers on each side. They just signed Adonai Kinsue. They just signed one of the best defensive coaches of all time. I mean, him coming to L.A., he'll be the next superstar. I think L.A. really needs it. Clippers are doing bad. Lakers are doing horrible. Rams had an awesome season. First time going to playoffs in 25 years. I mean, that's two decades, Coach. I mean, that is definitely a wish team, but I'm curious to see who would get him or where he would land, or even if the Giants would even give him up.
Yeah, I mean, L.A. would be a great market for him. He's a kind of athlete that really could benefit from being in a market like Los Angeles. I mean, that it's the type of market where he is going to really take off because the way that LA is going to embrace him.
He would definitely benefit in LA. I mean, Tinseltown, Hollywood. I mean, the guy's a walking advertiser. I mean, he's for the culture. I mean, he loves to dance. The kids love him. I mean, we haven't seen a player like this since Moss. Back in the day, when I was younger, kids used to say, "You got Moss." Now kids say, "You got Odell."
Yeah, he really became a verb, basically, which is crazy. I mean, when you become a verb, and think about how many players in the NFL can go by one name. Odell, like you say that and people know who you are. Even someone as big as Cam Newton, like he's one of those players that just has one name. So with a player with that kind of superstar prowess, I mean, a market like LA is pretty much the only place he could be. New York, if you're not in New York, I mean, that's another huge market. The only one, other one that can pretty much handle his superstardom is Los Angeles.
I agree. I totally agree. Sources very close. We got close sources. I really do, Coach. They say that Landry, his longtime college teammate, longtime friend, I mean, they have like a weird little bromance going on, but I mean, they're best friends, they're best buds. And he's even willing to take a pay cut from his new contract with the Cleveland Browns to bring his buddy, Odell, to Cleveland with Tyrod Taylor. Whoa.
Wow, I mean, that would be pretty crazy. But once again, we're talking about a market like that. Can it really handle that superstardom? I mean, is that the kind of place that a superstar player like him wants to go? I mean, this type of guy, he needs to be in a championship market. And, I mean, if it's not L.A., we're talking places like Chicago, Green Bay. I mean, you got to go somewhere where you can pretty much use his championship ability. This is a dynamic playmaker. I mean, look how he makes moves in the open space. There's no one within anywhere of him. I mean, this guy is amazing. Now there goes that raw energy again, but that's what you want. That's championship energy right there. Look how he just completely disrespected that cornerback. I mean, this guy is the ultimate.
But that's the thing, Coach. When he's on, I mean, he's on. But when he's off, he is a distraction. I mean, I've multiple times have seen this guy get a fit when he's facing a good corner that gets him frustrated, and it gets him totally out of his game. And matter of fact, it gets the whole offense out of rhythm. So this guy, I mean, hopefully he's matured. Fortunately, he has a lot of things in the media. I mean, he's getting sued for a lot of money. He's on video with random chicks with random things, allegedly drugs. We're not gonna, you know, confirm those sources. But the fact that you're putting yourself in that spotlight, I mean, he's clearly a superstar, but he clearly needs some guidance and he needs to mature a little bit in order to really, really excel in his career. I would hate to see this guy play two seasons, get traded, go to another team, and don't do diddly squat.
Yeah, I mean, you're right, Coach. Players can really get under this guy's skin because of that same emotional rawness that makes him such a dynamic and an awesome player on the field. Is the same thing that can hurt you when you get into his head. I mean, remember the situation he had with Josh Norman? I mean, Josh Norman really got under his skin and pretty much took away his playmaking ability. So, you know, that's the kind of thing that he has to learn how to grow and mature as a player. But one thing we have to remember, man, these guys are so young. Yeah, they're NFL players, but we put a lot of responsibility on top of them. But most of these guys are 22, 23 years old. I mean, think about how young Odell was when all that fame hit him. So he's still getting used to how to deal with it. And I'm not making excuses for him, but it's all part of the process of maturity. And I think that with the recent allegations and all the things that have come alongside with the stardom, I think it's kind of going to be a wake-up call where he's going to start to pay attention and do some self-reflection and hopefully start to apply and look at how some of the impact and things that he's doing may not be as beneficial for the team. But hey, man, I love this guy.
Well, I tell you what, if no one picks him up, I know who will. Dancing with the Stars. I mean, this guy dances. Any chance he gets, he is dancing. I mean, if he couldn't play football if he ever got hurt, I think he'll make it as a cheerleader for sure.
But that dancing ability is what makes him so elusive on the field. I mean, he's dancing between the hashes. I mean, this guy is pretty much untouchable in open space. He's so fast. He's elusive, great agility, cat-like moves. The guy is, you know, you see him and he's not that physically imposing, but he's so fast and so quick, and he just knows how to get and find the open space.
Honestly, Coach, I think he can be a distraction at times. I mean, we just talked about how he's so emotional. We just talked about his athletic ability. We talked later, there go the dancing. There he go, dancing. But you know what? He dances when he scores.
He danced on that route, too. He danced on that route and got open. I mean, you can only dance when you're in the end zone. So if he's always dancing, baby, that means he's always loud. Yeah, Peter Piper Pepper. Yeah, baby. So, I mean, my man is dancing because he's getting to where he needs to be. So, you know, every clip we're showing.
The MJ
said,
move.
Oh, yeah,
okay.
That was nice. That was good. Oh, yeah. Okay. Ooh, yep, there we go. Get him. See, look, at in the end zone again, getting his dance move. So, if you're in the end zone, I don't mind you dancing, Coach.
I understand that. But my thing is, the recent allegations, stay out the media, kid. Come on. I mean, you were hurt all season. So it's like, what have you done for me lately, all right? And that's how the game is. It's what have you done for me lately? And I think that's the reason why we're even talking about him right now, because, Odell, what have you done for me lately?
Coach. So let's talk about if he ends up on the Rams. Do you think the quarterback's going to be able to get the ball to him?
Well, you know what? This type of guy, I think my little sister could get the ball to him. But the only thing is, will he cry if it doesn't?
Yeah, I mean, it comes with the maturity of knowing and understanding your role in the offense. The Rams have a pretty explosive offensive package, and a lot of people on that team can do some really good things with the ball. So hopefully, if the Rams do get him, they get a mature version, and he really knows and understands how to play within their system. Look at that move. Wow.
The thing about the Rams, Coach, he won't be the focal of the offense. You have a stud running back over there named Todd Gurley that is phenomenal. I mean, this running back is awesome. So Odell would just be a compliment to the running game. And therefore, he wouldn't get double teamed. He'll put eight guys in a box, and he'll have his one-on-one matchup. So I think that move actually would make sense for the Rams. I mean, you got so many celebrities and Hall of Famers that could possibly take him under his wing and show him how to move out here in Hollywood, because obviously he's moving a little too fast.
Well, with that type of offensive prowess, it sounds like he might make even more plays, because if the offense is spread out and more balanced, I mean, it's difficult to double team him and triple team him like defensive have been. I mean, when you have an explosive guy like that on the end, and then you have an explosive, dynamic running back, I mean, that really opens up your offense.
Yeah, most definitely. And honestly, I don't even think the Giants going to get rid of him. I think the owner, I think he pulled a publicity move to see how much value he will get from him. And Odell, frankly, said he's not going on the field without a new contract. I mean, I understand. He's a superstar. He's still playing out his rookie contract. But I mean, look at this guy. You pay this man. Look at him. He's making catches in coverage with three guys around him. One-handed
catches.
Oh, my gosh. Whew.
I mean, this is the kind of guy, he was way underpaid for the past 3-4 years. And, you know, I think he was making something like $400,000 or $500,000 on that rookie contract. But he was given hundreds of millions of dollars of value. So, what do you think this guy is worth? I mean, what type of contract do you think that they're looking at for him if they re-sign him, the Giants?
Well, you're paying corners a lot of money these days. You're paying corners a lot of money to stop guys like this. Frankly, no one has stopped him. Well, honestly, there has been a few guys that got him frustrated, and he had
Josh
no production.
Norman.
Josh Norman is a cornerback from the Vikings. I can't remember his name, but I remember Odell crying because he couldn't get open off of that guy. So when you put a good corner in this guy's face, he's not doing all this track stuff. He's not doing all the dancing. He's frankly crying and hitting kicker nets. I mean, when it comes down to it, you know, it's like again, this league is what have you done for me lately. We're watching highlights all from his rookie season. So I think after his rookie season and sophomore season, I think he should have got that big contract, frankly, if you ask me. And if I was Odell, I'll be out of there.
Yeah, but the thing with the NFL, it's all about adjustments. I mean, by the time, you know, he was in his later seasons, the Giants had much less firepower as well. So it's kind of goes hand in hand. I mean, this guy, I would love to see him on the Rams. I think he would do a lot of really good things in L.A. You know, I'm a guy that loves to see people succeed beyond just their day-to-day job. And with him being in the NFL, you know, he's out here to make catches. But you don't want to see the guy succeed because the NFL is not going to last forever. And Los Angeles is the type of market that will set him up for additional opportunities after his playing days. You know, he could get involved in so many things. I mean, this guy, he's a beacon for the camera. You know, he could play soccer. I've seen him play basketball, Dancing with the Stars. I mean, L.A. is the market for this guy.
I mean, looking at these highlights, even Olympics might be the role for this guy. I mean, this guy's phenomenally fast. There's not else much to say about this guy. I mean, it's really comes down to, you know, what is it about? You know, do you want the money? Do you want the fame? Do you want to mature? Do you want to be great? Clearly, he wants to be great. Clearly, he wants to get paid. To the point that you said, this game doesn't last forever.
Hey, Coach, I got a random question for you. So if he made it out to L.A., do you think he could also play for the Los Angeles Football Club?
Honestly, this athlete, yes. He could play in that new stadium built right there down USC next to the Coliseum. That is not a plug because I did not go to USC.
Yeah, so it'll be interesting to see how this shapes out with Mr. Beckham. You know, you made an interesting scenario when you said he might, you know, link up with his old buddy Jarvis Landry. So I mean, we'll see how things play out. This is an interesting time. You know, he's all in the news for a number of different things. You know, I kind of dislike how, you know, a lot of times when things happen, you know, they get a lot of negative press and negative attention. But I'm all for seeing these guys really succeed, and I want these guys to do well. So, hey, man, I think hopefully he can work it out with the Giants and get what he's deserved so that he can benefit from the amount of equity that he's built there in New York. But, hey, out here in sunny Southern California, we'd love to have him. Mr. Beckham, we'd love to see you in that blue and yellow. So we'll see. It's an interesting time, and we'll see how things shape up.
Leave comments below. Click like.